No, I didn't wear it tonight. I went with the seal one tonight, but I wore the Iceman one for the
chalk war.
The chalk war, which we won. The offense took one.
Finally, it was about time. So so I just got the phone with our head coach real quick before I get in our 15 minutes. We have a potentially can play August 21st against Trinity at a Texas Trinity Center Cedar Hill in Texas on ESPN.
Nice.
Hoping that happens. Anyway, got some fun things I want to talk about tonight. And I think one of the main things, let me go right here, open this up. I'm the wide receiver coach at Madison Ridgeland Academy. Guys, we throw the ball a lot. I say a lot. We threw for 593 in the championship game. A lot of guys that don't know me on here. Four of my six receivers made All-State in the championship game. Four of them caught over 120 yards. Our quarterback just committed or is going to Mississippi Gulf Coast Community College, who won the JUCO National Championship this year. He was really the straw that stirs the drink in this whole thing when we got into wide receiver play. So what I started looking at, and this is – there's no data on this. I was looking at a way to get our guys better. And I think that's every coach, right? You want to be better than you were the year before, and that's why we're always trying to improve in some kind of scope. I wanted to look at how we can evaluate DBs and how we grade our opponent. So for me, people always ask, like, what do you look at on for a defense? Well, I could give two craps about the tackle box and the linebackers. We're wide split, so I'm looking at corners, overhangs, D-gap players, and safeties. So I want to say, look, what are some things we can look at and go into DB evaluation on our guys instead of looking at this whole big picture of who our guys are on Friday night? A lot of you are probably saying, well, we do that anyway. That's great. I never did. And I was like, let's put a little chart together. And I've been going through this with the summer with our guys. And then we're going to introduce this in fall camp, whoever our first opponent's going to be. We're going to get film on them. But this is my Twitter handle, at Coach Weaver MRA. That's my email, and that's my cell. Our motto is to the top. We take time of possession. We turn it to total offensive plays. So here's how we did this. I wanted to look at everybody and kids love, like, what's my star? Well, I'm leaving five stars up to those dudes that are, like, LSU and, like, Ohio State and all that stuff. I was like, I don't know any five stars in the state of Mississippi that well, that are DBs. So we went the four-star ranking. So how we grade them? One star, you're below average. Two-star, you're average. Three-star, you're above average. Four-star, you're being elite. And I went with four because it's easier to count even numbers for me than odd numbers. I'm just weird like that, I guess. But here's what it does. It allows us to rank our opponent. And I thought that was big because our guys would, a lot of times, and maybe your high school kids do this because mine definitely do, they go look at their opponent, and they end up watching the ball more than they watch the guy that they're going against. So I think it's real big in a hero line coach who Kenny Williams does a fantastic job with our O-line of, hey, know what your opponent's tendencies are on the D-line. Like, how are they going to rip? How are they going to, you know, what are they going to try to roll and shoulder you on this? Are they, you know, what are their tendencies? What, are they going to try to bull rush you at the nose? So I was like, you know what? I can take that and put it out in space with DB. So it allows us to rank our opponent easier. It's going to prepare us for what we'll see on Friday night. So the tendencies that I gain from my kids watching. So, look, it's great if we watch it and grade these guys out. I'm going to flip the script. I'm going to have my own grade on Saturday and Sunday after I start watching film. When they get film, they're going to look at who they're going against on Friday night and start grading out that guy. And then we're going to mimic tendencies that we will see on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday for what they're going to see on Friday, and that's where you go to the third one, is game tendencies of what that guy's going to do. So how is he in man coverage? And I'll show you what we break down there. There are 10 things that we break down. And then also it's almost like the water boy. And I thought about this when I was making this whole thing up this summer, is the onside kick. And he's scanning. He goes, there's my, and you know what he's looking at for the onside kick. And it's the guy that's shaking and all that stuff. So we want to see who we can attack on certain plays on the defense. So how we did it. We looked at man coverage. How are they in man coverage, right? Versus how are they in zone coverage? Well, then every DB has press man tendency. So all this social distancing, you couldn't play 7-on-7. Our wide receivers know our boundary corners press man tendencies and our field corner press man tendencies. They know how they are in man coverage and zone coverage. So the first 4 weeks of summer, we weren't doing too hot against them. Now they're just eating them up. We're also going to look, do they backpedal or do they shuffle? And how well do they do it? That's another tendency part. And then how are they against the run? Okay, so that's going to help our run game. And then it's also going to say, hey, how hard are we going to block this guy? Do we need to block this guy? What do the cutoff rules need to be on this guy? Does he run away when the run's coming at him, or does he attack hard? Does he like to press inside? Does he like to, like every defensive coach, they don't let him outside of you. You got to set the edge. So we look at those five things. Then we look at tackling. How well do they tackle? And then I look at speed and explosiveness. I look at how smart they are. Do they blow coverages? Toughness, and then ball skills. So those are the 10 things that we look at. And like I said, there's no data on this. We were kind of compiling this together for the summer of like, hey, need to look at speed, need to look at explosiveness, need to look at tackling. How smart are they? Do they blow coverages a lot? If they do, look, go with that dude. How tough are they? And that all goes into the stuff of how are they in man coverage, zone coverage, press man tendencies, backpedal, shuffle, and how are they against the run? So how we figure it out? We're going to add up these stars, and I got a sample sheet on this next one, and I'll show you how we're going to go through it. We're going to add up the stars. We're going to evaluate the tendencies. We're going to rank the DB on each. So we might be going against Joe Smith, who's number five for Timbuktu U, and that DB, the DB to the field is a two-star on press man. And maybe he's a four-star on zone, and he's a four or a three on tackling. You know, we're going to start finding those strengths and those weaknesses of what guys can do and what they can't do, and how defensive coordinators try to hide guys maybe in the secondary, like little league guys get hidden in right field. So here's what it's going to look like. Here's a sample eval sheet. It's real simple. Our guys will have this. I'm going to rank every DB that comes and steps on the field for the teams that we're going to play. Our guys are going to go, if they're an outside R or L, so we don't use X or Z, we use R or L. That's how simple we are, right or left. They're going to grade the DB that comes on them. If they're slots, they're going to look at safeties and overhang players, and they're going to start writing tendencies. So this isn't for me. Like, if I know it, that's great, but our kids need to know it and rep it during practice. So we'll go man coverage, zone coverage. We'll give them press man, backpedal or shuffle, which one do they do? We give them a star against the run. How are they? How are they? It's tackling all those 10 things that I said, and then we'll add up their stars. Now, if somebody's got a better way, I'd love to hear it. I'd love to talk to you. But I think by adding up those stars and then dividing them by those 10 will give us what type of player that is on a Friday night. But then if I want to look at him, how is he in man coverage and press man and probably tackling those three? If he's a three on that, it means he's above average, right? So he's going to be pretty good at the point of attack versus, say, he's terrible in zone and he doesn't have speed and explosiveness. We can run by that cat. So those are some things we're going to look at, and then our guys have this big box right here to write down tendencies. So they'll write the DB's name or the safety's name or the D-gap player that's on them, put their number, and then they'll start ranking them, and then they'll do the total stars, and they'll put right below here what his star average is in those tendencies. I'm going to show you some huddle film real quick of how we're going to do this whole thing. So obviously we're going to look at press man, and this dude right here and this dude up here were two really good cats on Friday night when we played Briarcrest out of Tennessee. But you can see they both have different tendencies. So we'll talk about this guy right here.
I think you got to change your screen, man.
Oh, man.
You might have to reshare.
It's been a long day.
That's all right.
Thanks for – I bet everybody's like, what the hell is he drawing? Hold on. Let me get to it. Sorry about that. Cut into my 15 minutes. I'm trying to go as fast as I can. Is that better?
There we go. Now you're good.
Okay. So these two dudes – this guy and this guy are totally different. So we're going to look at press man. And I want you to watch how they have different tendencies. So we're going to watch the guy at the top first, how he pops and stays square until the receiver makes a move versus the tendency of the one right here where we're going to rep that during practice when we're doing our drills and into the individual time of press man. Well, he's going to open up and use the 12th man, the sideline, to close us out. So right there, you're going to see two types of press man. I'd say this guy is probably better at it than this guy. And then we'll look at how is this over the slot. So we'll evaluate that as well and give him a star. All right, so he's peeking inside. So man coverage on this dude, he's peeking inside, not even worrying about us. This guy will probably be below average. Right? So just based on tendencies, and we'll watch a whole game and go through scout film on this. So here it is again. Once again, he's peeking. Obviously, he has safety help over the top, so he can peek in on the run. Let me see if I can find a run play on how they are on tackling. But late to run support, obviously they're in man. Let me go early on in the game. I'll show you another game. Let's go here where a team is in zone. Like I said, Drew, this is probably stuff that people do all the time. I like systems and ways to do things that makes it easy for not just coaches, but for athletes to gain advantages on Friday night. Yeah, so here we are in zone. We knew early that this guy, when he shuffles out, he puts his butt to the field. So easy post turn on that dude all day long. So that would be a tendency that we look at, and we start adding up all these stars. And here's one where you look, and this is why we started looking at this. So just like I did our catching drills for us on Friday nights for practice, I went, what kind of catches do we make on Friday nights here? So I'm going to go look through the whole season because obviously we're playing these dudes again, but they're going to have different players, but they're going to have some of the same tendencies. Like these two, this guy are the same guy, and this guy, they're all coming back. So once again, you can see the discrepancy because no two DBs are cut exactly alike. But how he shuffles with himself to the field, if you look at the guy at the top versus the one at the bottom that automatically turns. Here it is here. We knew early. So this goes in to help with play caller. So our head coach is the offensive coordinator as well. So we evaluated that during film and said, hey, we're going to be able to get a post on this guy into the boundary if he's ever there. And sure enough, we pop a post on him. So just ways to look at DBs, to evaluate those DBs, and to gain some tendencies on Friday night. Any coaches have any questions? Guess not. I mean, Drew, it's pretty simple. We're going to look into that, and we'll have more data on this, on how we're going to grade these guys. But I think it's imperative that for coaches to have some type of system. We go fast, and we're going to be able to catch people doing different things and going in different ways. Catching them like as a three technique, lined up in a 4-eye, and we catch him off guard, because we're going so fast. But I think it's imperative for us to go and have a system, and our guys can rep this at practice. They can go through, and now they have a cheat sheet, if you will, on watching guys, because I think high school kids, they look at themselves a lot, and they follow the ball a lot. So this is going to give them a way to give them a sheet, and, hey, let's start grading out with this what this DB does well, what he does not do well, and how can we gain advantage on Friday nights.
Awesome, man.